Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. Let's go to Paul in St. Paul. That must be very confusing. Paul of St. Paul. Go ahead.
Well, I know you from listening to you, you're generally very consistent in your stances. And I just wanted you to elaborate on your differences between, or why you don't really care for Donald Trump, but you do seem to like Ann Coulter. I mean, just in the context of the personalities, not that I know one happens to be one of the
greatest. Ann Coulter has, I spoke about this earlier in the show, in the first hour, and I didn't speak about Ann Coulter, I spoke about Donald Trump, but I spoke about this subject. The subject being that over the course of a lifetime, you earn your moral bank account. Ann Coulter has a conservative, lifelong moral bank account. Donald Trump has nothing in the bank. Nothing. Zero. That's the difference.
Well, I just don't think she's very helpful to our cause.
That way, that's just what your view of her is. That's fine. You could hold that. But her books are truly significant works. Whatever you think of her persona, I thought she was totally off base with her foolish tweet on the Jews thing. And I know her excuse, and I know her very well. She made a mistake. She should have said it and moved on. But I wrote for the Jerusalem Post a piece defending her against the charge of anti-Semitism because she doesn't have an anti-Semitic bone in her body, to the best of my knowledge, and I know her pretty well. So whether you think that she is a virtue or not in conservatism is irrelevant. What matters is that she has a lifetime of proof of commitment to a cause. Donald Trump has zero. The only cause Donald Trump has lived for is Donald Trump's money. He has no other background. That's his life. Why that appeals to conservatives is one of the great riddles of our time. That's all he's done in 69 years is make money. I have no problem with that, but it doesn't qualify you to be a conservative, let alone a president. There's no comparison between the two people. She's devoted her life to profoundly good works in her books, making the case for the values she believes in, and in most instances that I believe in. Okay?
All right. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. I'm a big believer in moral bank account. What you've done with your 69 years matters. Okay? It matters. I'm not saying it's bad that all he has done in his life is make money. I'm a capitalist. More power to him. It just doesn't qualify you to be president. It qualifies you to be a moneymaker. Petoskey, Michigan, and Randy. Hello, Randy. Dennis Prager.
Hey, Dennis. We're one of your affiliates up here in northern Michigan, WYPV.
Terrific. Hi. Thank you.
You're welcome, sir. And also, I'm the chairman of the Antrim County Republican Party. And in talking to a lot of our Republican members, and many of these people are lifelong Republicans, very staunch conservatives. The main reason I think they're supporting Trump, and reading the article that National Review put out by their editors this morning, is that they don't believe the establishment anymore. They don't even believe the people who are the editors making up National Review, is that they're to the point where they are so anti-establishment and anti even their own conservative beliefs. I read the article on the radio show this morning where they pointed out all these policy positions of Trump and who he's donated to and single-payer health care and on and on and on.
And recommends that his sister, who is on the left, be a Supreme Court justice.
Exactly. It's like they are so mad and frustrated.
You're right. And you know what? I have complete identity with their madness, or if you will, anger and frustration.
Yep.
And I have no I have no identification with using that to make my decisions in life. That is the difference between rational humans and emotional humans. I make my decisions with my mind, not my heart.
And the thing of it, I think, just final point, is that you would help the movement, the conservative movement, for you explaining exactly that point, that the people need to think instead of feel, because he is operating, Trump is operating with the exact motive operandi that Bush or that Obama did of hope and change. He simply, you know, make America great again.
That's right. That is correct.
No details, yes. In-depth discussion of how he's going to do it.
Now, can you name one advisor he has on foreign policy? Which is the biggest? Which is the big? They don't exist. They don't exist because he's so arrogant. He thinks he knows all he needs to know about foreign policy, and he knows nothing. He knows we'll kill him. We'll kill him. We'll kill him. The arrogance to not have foreign policy advisors when you run for the president of the United States—it's arrogance if you have no foreign policy advisor if you run for Congress. But none of it matters. None of it matters because my arguments are appeal to reason, and support for him is not based on reason. And I know that many good people who support Trump, but you're being guided by your heart, not your mind.